The great unknown is, what is Russian President Vladimir Putin thinking? This week, U.S. and U.K. officials said they believe that he felt misled by his advisors, given unreliable sources, so to speak. In the words of one official, we believe Putin's advisors are afraid to tell him the truth. Of course, his propaganda machine within Russia spread his lies through state-run media, so Russian folks have not heard the truth from official sources either. This real concept that Putin was misled, the public was misled in Russia, how much of that has contributed to this doomed war? A lot of questions. Let's get into it with Julia Ioffe, founding partner and Washington correspondent for PUC. And Ivan Kolpakov, he's the editor-in-chief of Russian independent news outlet Meduza, and he joins us from Latvia today. Ivan, I'd like to start with you and what Meduza is. I know some CNN viewers know it well. Others are hearing about it for the first time. You are an English-language news outlet covering Russia for Russians, and you've been having to rebuild your newsroom because of sanctions recently. Tell us first, do you have a sense? Do you buy into the U.S. and U.K. officials saying that Putin was misled by his advisors and that Putin doesn't know the truth about what's happened in Ukraine?
I think that many of this is unfortunately true. I think that Putin for a long period of time was convinced by the propaganda narrative his team provided to himself. So he constructed a huge propaganda narrative about Ukraine as a failed state, and he actually believed that. That's the problem.
He got high on his own supply, so to speak. Julia, you wrote for PUC this week that now he's a prisoner of his own propaganda. What does that mean?
Well, what we're seeing is that when the Russian delegation to the talks in Istanbul announced that they were starting to get closer to the Ukrainian position, that they might drop some of Russia's demands, for example, trying to force Ukraine to make Russian one of its official languages, There was an uproar on Russian social media, including from people like Ramzan Kadyrov, the head of Chechnya, who is very loyal, including the head of Russia Today, Margarita Simonyan, who said, this is an outrage, this is a betrayal, we were promised total victory. And so now there's no room to retreat from the maximalist demands that Putin has made. And one of the hopes that had been expressed in Washington and Brussels and London was that maybe Putin could take a settlement and then use the propaganda machine back home to spin it as a great victory.
Right.
And that seems to not be happening just yet.
So you quoted a person in your piece saying what Putin fears is pro-war protests, that his audience, his public is going to demand the war to continue. That's a frightening concept.
Yeah, well, they've been, for the last few months, the Russian propaganda machine has been train the Russian public to want blood. And now they want blood. They've been promised blood. They've been promised total victory, that they would defeat Nazism in Ukraine, which is, for a country that sees its role historically as having beat Nazism in World War II, they see it as a sacred duty. And so why would you only go halfway if we're fighting Nazis?
You have been supportive of Meduza. That's why I wanted the two of you on together. You've been supportive of Ivan. Tell me why first of all, Ivan, tell us about why you needed support, why you needed donations. What happened in Meduza when the war began that required you to call out for more donations?
Yeah, well, actually, Meduza right now is the biggest Russian independent media outlet that actually keeps covering the war in Ukraine and can reach out people in Russia, because as many Russian independent publications, we were blocked during the war. However, we've been prepared for that for so many years. We've been thinking that we're going to be blocked at some point, and eventually it happened. But also, the war and the Western sanctions crushed our crowdfunding campaign. Before the war, we had 33,000 regular supporters in Russia, and now we can't get any money from Russia anymore. So what we did a couple weeks ago, we established a new wave of our crowdfunding focused on Western audiences, on people who live in Europe and in the United States. And we are asking these people to replace our supporters from Russia, because we think that the journalism is actually an international value and an international language. I'm pretty sure that there are a lot of people in Europe and in America who believe just as we do, that you can't solve the problem, you can't stop this war without providing independent information in Russia. Mm.
Julia, you put this on my radar. You were messaging me about this, saying this is an important campaign. Tell me your perceptions of how many folks inside Russia, inside the country, are able to and are interested in accessing content like Ivan's.
Well, if you have a VPN, if you're interested, you can get it. And personally, I check Meduza several times a day. It's my first stop in the morning, last stop in the evening. It is primarily a Russian news site, but it has an excellent English site, an excellent English daily newsletter. And again, if Russians don't know what their country is doing, how can they be expected to press the government to do anything else? Mm. And I agree with Ivana, and I would actually reframe it. I would say, you know, it's not just donations. You're paying for a product. This is information that is vital, that is important. This is basically a subscription. This stuff can't be and shouldn't be done for free. These people should be paid to do the excellent work that they're doing.
Again, I
personally, this is what I start my day with. This is what I finish my day with. Mm. This is my first stop to get information on what's happening in Ukraine is Meduza.
And what are you looking at this week as we see these Russian forces retreating, horrific images of mass graves and civilians shot in the streets? What are you looking for in this week ahead?
Well, I'm going to look to see how the international community responds, because one of Putin's goals has always been to show the hollowness and the hypocrisy of the Western order, right, of the U.S.-led order. And, you know, are there more sanctions? Is the West going to continue buying Russian oil and gas, as Slovakia just said it would do? So far, the new sanctions that have been announced do not include cutting off Russian oil and gas to Europe. So, you know, I guess Putin is calling the West bluff, right? What is the point of the UN? What is the point of the EU and NATO if it allows such atrocities to keep happening?
All right, much more to come. Julia and Ivan, thank you both.